Okay, let's talk. I'll help remove your pain with some love, okay? When you look at the solar system, there's 9 planets, right? According to Neil deGrasse Tyson, the alleged rapist. They're all spinning in the same direction. You know the odds of that? 2 to the 9th power, 1 in 512. That's very rare. And by the way, do not, during this conversation, do not say it was God's will. Because if you use God, you have to read the Bible. And the Bible does not depict the earth as a spinning ball in a sea of nothing at all. So you can't have it both ways, guys. You can't have a firmament, four corners, God sits up and looks at us like grasshoppers. You can't have that and a spinning ball and nothing. Okay, listen, just please listen, because it's impossible. All right, next up on the solar system model, it's on a flat plane. Not just is the solar system a flat plane, the entire Milky Way galaxy is a flat plane. Want to talk about flat Earth? Oh, flat earthers. You're saying that after a big bang, even with the law of thermodynamics called entropy, which we'll get to in a second, somehow our galaxy ended up being a perfectly flat plane where all the planets spin in the same direction. The odds of that are less than winning the Mega Lotto every single day for thousands of years. Understand that. Now look at the moon. The moon is a perfect circle. The odds that that happened after big bang and just chaos of atoms and particles and dust and rocks colliding is zero. The odds are literally zero. There's no force. There's no wind. There's no erosion. There's no water. There's no force acting upon that moon that would make it a perfect sphere. Next up, why are the craters all perfect spheres? The way asteroids hit, side, angle, we've never witnessed an asteroid, okay? The odds that the spin of the moon is exactly the same speed as it rotates around the Earth, again, are zero. If it was 1/4 of 1 mile per hour different, it would slowly turn. The fact it doesn't, and there is zero physics explanations with the model of gravity as we know it to explain why the moon, why its axis rotation is exactly matching it rotate around us so that we only see one side. Light being shined upon a sphere does not make the luminescence the same all the way across. You can do a test with a tennis ball and a flashlight. It's impossible. It can't happen. It only happens on two-dimensional objects. Seeing as you've only seen one side of the moon because of its miraculous rotation and its perfect circle, and the fact that the luminescence is the same across the whole thing implies, I'm not stating this, it implies it's a two-dimensional object. A lot more than it's a spinning sphere out of the chaos of the Big Bang, okay? The size and weight of the moon, according to science, it is impossible for it to be rotating around our Earth. The way the Earth was, the way the moon was created according to mainstream science is that an object the size of Mars hit our Earth and created the moon. That's nonsense. We would have rings like Saturn. Where's all the dust? Where's all the debris? Where's everything? That all just disappeared? That makes no sense at all. Next up, the sun is 400 times bigger and miraculously 400 times farther away than the moon. And like two machine cut quarters, they line up perfectly to make an eclipse. The odds of that are 1 in trillions times 1 in trillions times 1 in trillions. It's not possible. That the perfect circles in this world, which can't happen on the moon given the existing model, line up perfectly with something 400 times larger from a third factor, which is your fixed position on an Earth that they claim is spinning 1,000 miles an hour. Okay, the shadow of the eclipse is 70 miles wide. There is no way to make a shadow smaller than the object. Of course, there are people that say umbra because, like goats, they've been trained to say that, but they cannot recreate an umbra on Earth. They only believe it because they've been indoctrinated to believe it since the time of their birth by people who want to remove their connection to God. Okay, next up, evolution. So we have something called the Big Bang, which is the ultimate chaotic event. What banged? Who banged it? Why did it bang? How did everything come from a fixed point? Don't even try and tackle that because it makes zero sense. But here's something that you can easily think of, and it disproves everything about mainstream science. The law of entropy is that matter and energy naturally go from order to chaos. If you break a glass, even after a billion years, the broken shards will not reform into the glass, because objects have a tendency towards entropy, towards dissolving, towards breaking apart. Whether it's empires or a broken glass, the longer you wait, the more the broken shards become sand. They get ground down, they will never go the other direction. So how do we have a human eyeball from a Big Bang? The Big Bang happens and it creates a never-ending waterfall, cascade, domino effect of atoms smashing against each other in an empty darkness for eternity. So given the law of entropy that things go from order to chaos, how on earth do we have the structure of a human eyeball in which we can see light and then recreate the light in our minds as images that represent our physical reality. It contradicts to a point of laughable mockery. Okay, now understand that if anyone says, well, sexual selection, Big Bear, you know, over long periods of time, I used to believe this stuff too. I believed all of it. I loved astronomy. I minored in evolution in college. I loved thinking about how the environment would interact with a human being, increase their odds of procreation or decrease their odds of procreation, and certain genes would pass. Nonsense. You're telling me that that force that created the human eyeball, which is unbelievably complicated, that through a long process of light hitting cells and then becoming rods and cones, if that's from sexual selection, why does our skin burn in the sun? Why do I need an umbrella right now so that my skin doesn't become red and cancerous? Well, Big Bear, it's because you're from the north. Why don't I have hair on my body? Why would I die outside in 30 degree weather without a structure around me? If my people came from Northern Europe, which they did for so long, how come I didn't evolve to not die in the snow and then die in the sun? If sexual selection actually had an impact on us, like they say it did, if we can evolve to have the complexity of a human eyeball out of a Big Bang, even though that goes against entropy, why on earth have we evolved to not have skin that's resistant to the one constant in our life at all times, which is the sun and then the winter? It doesn't make any sense, right? So what is the point of all of this? Is this supposed to give you despair and fear? No, it's removing it. We were created. That glass that was broken was a glass because someone made it. So someone made us to have eyes to see, ears to hear, a mouth to taste, hands to touch, a woman to love, a child to hold, right? That is love. And so what's the purpose of life? Serving that which gave us all of it, God. And they want you to think that we are on a spinning ball in an infinite black, and every atom that just smashes together randomly eventually became your parents who randomly fucked and are now silently watching NCIS in some long, weird, passive-aggressive game, and you're just here to randomly smash your genitals against someone. No fucking way, guys. That's despair. That's the world where you need medication to get out of bed. That's the world where you can be easily tricked because you have nothing to be grateful for or nothing to live for. When you know that your eyes of your children were created, that means whoever created it loves you. So serve that who loves you, which is your creator. There is no way that that moon just got this. The story is an endless serpent distracting you from God's love and making you sad and full of despair. And every time I point out one of these deceptions and people say, oh, I can't be with you on this one, man. It's too much stress. I'm removing the stress. You're made in love. Your soul matters. Your choices matter. God loves you. Why would God give you eyes that can see your wife holding a baby that came out of chaos? No. Why would God make all these unbelievable nonsense things that that everyone tries to explain away, explain away, explain away? None of the scientists have any cohesion whatsoever. You know, they just changed the time frame of the Big Bang by 1 billion years, and no one batted an eye because they are not walking with God. Serve, have gratitude. When you have gratitude towards your creator, and all it's so simple. Just be thankful every day. Be thankful that this was created, that this isn't random results of genital smashing. And then when you're thankful, when you say, thank you, God, God says, no problem. God is everything. Guys, this is created out of love and form. And when you see it, your life has more form and order and beauty and love. You can forgive. You can call out bullshit. You can get mad and not be scared that you're bubbling with rage. The purpose of your life is to have gratitude and purpose and serve God, that which made you. That science didn't give you eyes. Random fucking over a billion years didn't give you ears. God did. And that's logic. Do you think logic and math explains how our fucking solar system and galaxy is a straight flat plane? And even though we have the law of entropy, for some reason, the most complicated physical things that we can't imagine just came out of fucking? You're out of your mind. That is the illogic. Logic comes from a word, guys. Logos, logic. It's the same word, the word. God, form, natural law. It's all the same thing. You know what is real and what is not real. And when you know, truth will set you free. Work will set you free. Labor, truth, love, family, soil. That's what's real. Then you won't fall for these tricks